All right, the Charlotte Major came to a close, so really there's just one more game to talk about. This video is, I suppose, like a day late, but it is what it is. Also, due to unfortunate circumstances, I'm holding my microphone, so hopefully that doesn't cause me to make any insane noises on the microphone. I'll try to keep this relatively brief. We'll see where we actually land. Dark Zero versus Astralis was the grand final of the event. NA versus NA, this is the first time in a very long time where the grand final has been NA versus NA, and thus guaranteeing an NA victor. And it was Dark Zero that took it home 3-2. So no lower bracket, no map advantage, none of that. So we went all five maps. And this is one of only a handful of times we've gone all five maps. The casters were recounting a few times, and then they missed a few times, and then they eventually corrected themselves. But hasn't been that many times, so a pretty hype series. This could have easily been a 3-0 had things gone slightly differently, and we'll talk about that in just a second. Okay, so the map vetoes, CGG doesn't have it entirely accurate here. The system is 4 best of 5, ban, pick, ban. So these picks came before these bans, so just keep in mind, Astralis had the choice of Villa or, this Cafe wasn't already banned out, so either of these teams could have opted for one of these two maps before they ended up getting banned out. And so Villa by Astralis, I guess it worked out for them in the end, as we'll see in just a second. They could have opted, maybe Theme Park was a better choice, but I don't know, it's all hindsight from here. They probably didn't really want to play Cafe. They do end up banning it. And also, not so curiously, Dark Zero forces them to play Clubhouse. So they had a few interesting strats, that is Astralis, because they'd never played Clubhouse. Pretty good map for Dark Zero, and Astralis has basically permabanned it, and finally in the best of five, they couldn't keep it permabanned. And again, some interesting strats, but it didn't really work out for them. They lost pretty dominantly on this map. So let's look at the actual scores for the maps. So 7-8 on Villa, and then Dark Zero wins the next two maps. So if that 15th round had just gone the other way, then it would have been a clean 3-0 for Dark Zero. That would have been very unfortunate. That last round was super hype. Shuttle gets an ace in the very last round, and NJR is one of the last two people alive or something, and he dropped 20 kills on the map. So unfortunate for him that he couldn't lock in an excellent map by securing it in the clutch. But again, it did provide a much better series. So we go on to Clubhouse. Villa was, of course, Astralis' map pick, so good that they won it. We go on to Clubhouse, and whatever Astralis had cooked up wasn't nearly enough. They lost 7-3 pretty dominantly. Then we go to Border, and this felt like it should have been an Astralis victory. It was their map after all, and the last three maps don't matter too much whose map it is, because at that point, because of the picks and the bans that have already gone through, the last three maps are guaranteed. It's just the order. So we went to Border, and Astralis, I think the only time that they played it, they beat Space Station 7-5, and Dark Zero, did they play this against, is that where they played Sonics? That might have been their only play. I don't recall off the top of my head. But so both of them, I think, solid on Border, but a little bit surprisingly, it was a Dark Zero victory. And then going on to Oregon, this is the map that Astralis absolutely crushed Oxygen on the day before. It was a 7-1 scoreline. This is also the map that the two teams played each other on in the NAL, and that was an 8-6 victory for Astralis. And here they are winning it again, so looking pretty good. They have the momentum going into the final map, and again, a solid map for both of them. In hindsight, I'm not entirely sure who this seems to have favored. I think Bank felt about even. Astralis maybe a little bit, or Oregon a bit Astralis-sided maybe. Villa even-ish, maybe a little bit Astralis-sided, and then Clubhouse, definitely Dark Zero, and then Border about even. So I guess in theory it almost seemed like Astralis, but I think the advantages in some cases were pretty slight, or they're made up for in some other capacity. But in the end, I guess Bank was a lot better for Dark Zero. I don't know if it had to do so much with the map. It definitely had to do, of course, with the map. But going into that map 5, a very, very long series, they played, of course, 5 maps. Only overtime here. Interestingly, they decided not to do infinite overtime here. Don't know why they did that, but they did. So this could have gone differently, but again, no infinite overtime. So 7-3, Astralis might have just run out of gas in the tank, but one way or another, they were definitely outclassed by the time that they got to Bank. And so Dark Zero, a few interesting trends in all three of their playoff games. So against Team One, against Team Liquid, and now against Astralis, they lost the first map and then they won the next two. But of course, in the best of five, that doesn't secure it. So then Astralis took a map, Dark Zero. So in all of their series, they lost the first map, they won the next two. Also is true that they lost the first map and won the final map to win the series. So I mean, good for Eclipse and Hyper, who have been playing for a very long time and don't have a ton to show for it. NJR and Pamazu, two newer-ish players, and, I mean, a lot of prize money and a good accolade already under their belt. And Canadian, I mean, maybe we'll discuss it in another video, but I think at this point he is the GOAT of Siege, surpassing Pengu. If there was, I suppose there were definitely doubts before, and a lot of people still do have doubts now, but I think a lot of people are saying that is very clearly Canadian based on what he has done. And so I guess we'll look at the stats here. Oh, really quickly, I'm surprised by this. Astralis is favored in the community predictions because at the event, Dark Zero had far, far more people cheering for them. So I don't know if that, I don't know why that is, why the predictions weren't reflected in the crowd sentiment. And then, yeah, I guess we'll look at the player stats. So J9O, a little bit of a standout, I mean, relatively so for his team. The only one to go positive in terms of kills and positive in terms of rating as well. Forest, second best player. I mean, I think he ended up being probably the, well, I think Iconic ends up with a 0.02 higher rating for the event overall, but Forest is on like hard support and Iconic is on entry, so I think Forest was the most impressive player in this event for Astralis. And yeah, nobody doing too poorly here. I think Iconic was the big letdown though. He really wasn't getting the frags like he needed to do to win this series. And again, you know, nothing too terrible over here. Iconic and DBFire both at minus 11. A bit lackluster. And then over on Dark Zero, it felt like Pambazoo was the one that really took over, but NJR had such an incredible first map that I guess it put him over Pambazoo. Pamba, if I remember right, had the second, third maps were really good for him, and then he didn't do as much in the final two maps. And especially on Bank, it was sort of a really real team effort, and maybe it was like Eclipse that was doing especially, it was somebody who was doing very well. I think they all had a pretty good map, except for maybe Canadian. I don't know if he had any standout maps, but still doing fine, minus two, whatever. It is what it is when you are the IGL. So Pamazoo named the MVP for the event, and I mean, I think rightfully so. The performance he put up against Liquid, I don't know if they would have made it past Liquid without him, and unfortunately for NJR, in this grand final, a good bulk of his stats did come in a map that they lost, so maybe things could be recontextualized slightly if they had won Villa and thus it been a 3-0, but because Pambazoo showed up big in some of the maps that they did win in this grand final, as opposed to NJR, what I just said. Yeah, I mean, I think Pamazoo deserves it pretty well. He was insane in a ton of games, not every single game, of course, you know, can't always be incredible, but he was quite good. Eclipse, very solid performance from him, moving over to the hard support not too long ago. Hyper, a bit lukewarm of a performance, I think overshadowed quite a bit by NJR and Pamazoo, but still being a good character on this cast. And then, of course, Canadian, as I mentioned, the GOAT. The stats aren't great, but, I mean, you can't understate his impact on this team. They went from, I mean, always being that like top four team, going to like every event, but never winning anything. And then Canadian comes on this team like 9 months later, they win this event. Incredible. And so I guess that's really all I want to talk about. I'll just leave this here and I'll look at the whole stats in a separate video. I'll do like an event overview sort of thing probably, but I'll just leave the grand final talk for this one, and I think that's pretty much all I have to say. I guess one last thing, yeah, I'm a bit disappointed Astralis didn't win. I suppose it was a good storyline for either of them. Astralis, a massive comeback from stage three, picking up Forest and Callout and then making it this far, and I mean, a bit of a comeback for Canadian. I think a lot of people think he was washed. A lot of people were quite verbal about it, you know, impressive accolades in the past. The first six invitational on, I guess it was what, Continuum at the time, but became Evil Geniuses, basically the same thing, same roster, and that was a bit early days, the competition wasn't too fierce, and then he won SI 2020 on a different team, super impressive, but he just didn't have maybe the sheer accolades of say, Pengu, but to come back a third time in another vastly different era, it's been, I guess, over 2 years since SI 2020, and to win another major event, it's not quite an SI, but a major is still, well, a major, and maybe, you know, a little bit of a Mickey Mouse thing, Elevate wasn't here, circumstances for some of the LATAM teams, whatever, I don't think it really puts an asterisk on what Canadian has done. And I mean, I'm looking forward to see what he's doing. Somebody asked me maybe if he would like retire after this, but Canadian doesn't really strike me as a retire on top kind of guy. I think he has a little bit more in the tank. Maybe he'll have some more impressive performances with Dark Zero in the NAL. Maybe even we'll see him back in another playoffs. Maybe we'll see him lifting another trophy. We'll have to see. But I guess I intend to hopefully do a little bit of a Canadian versus Pengu GOAT kind of thing, and maybe I'll talk about Astralis also in a separate video, but we'll see. So, yeah, I'm pushing the 10-minute mark, so I guess I'll cut it off here. If you have any comments regarding, well, whatever, you know, leave them below, and a like and a subscription would be appreciated. So with all of that being said, I will catch you guys in the next video.